The last thing we're going to talk on the swing is breathing, proper breathing. There's a lot of ways you can breathe. Just like when we're doing that stretch, like passive breathing, exhaling, good for relaxing. You know what I mean? Like when we're doing this, when we're doing that, bending forward here, like relaxing. When you exhale, passive exhale through your mouth, your muscles have a tendency to relax. Like I don't know if you ever get like that sports massage on you, or somebody's working that trigger point, you're like, you feel like tapping out, and you're like, breathe. You're like, ah. You know, it's just like you're trying to relax that muscle, right? You know, conversely, when you breathe through your teeth, like, and when it's compressed, like a fighter, like a boxer, like every time he's throwing a punch, he's like, you know, it's not because it sounds cool or anything like that. Because what it is like when you let little air coming through your teeth, it actually contracts your abs, increases your intra-abdominal pressure, and actually makes your muscles contract harder, so you can hit harder, have more power and all that. Well, the same thing here with the kettlebell, right? So what we're gonna do is breathing on the way down, we're gonna breathe through our nose, right? You're gonna put air in our abs. Like put your hands right here, right here on the sides. And just as you inhale and try to like put all the air in your lower abs right there, right? You guys feel that right there? Okay, more air you put in your abs, kind of protects your back. Now, when we exhale, right, keep your hands right there. Like that, feel those abs kind of contract. Like that, it's just like you're taking a shot, right? You always exhale, bam, just a little bit of air. Same thing. Now when we apply that to the kettlebell, it's like this. I'll sit up here, inhale through my nose, get air in my abs, right? And just like that. Okay? And put it down. So we're just coordinating the breath with the movement. You know, and it'll give you a little more power. I like to save the breathing for last, but say you got a client that has like a bad back. Dude, before they even pick up that kettlebell, I show them the breathing sequence. You know what? Whenever you pick it up, before you do their first swing, have them set up, inhale through their nose, put air in their abs, you know, then go through it. Show them the, you know, proper way to breathe. Putting air in your abs is huge for lower back safety, and plus it applies too to deadlifting, you know what I mean? Deadlifting, anything else where, you know, whenever you're bent over, like, inhaling, the only thing that's different is when you exhale, again, you're matching the breath to the movement, but it's slower and it's more drawn out, and it's gonna get you stronger and stronger. Same thing, if you got foam, buddy down drills, you gotta pick somebody up. Boom, take a half second, inhale, tighten up, pick them up. It's gonna save, even if you're in an awkward position, it's gonna save your back. It's real important, have the intra-abdominal pressure, pressurizing, and working it. So breathing is real important.